In the last video session, we have done several examples. That is how to implement different type of endpoint like a get mapping, post mapping, put mapping, and delete mapping. And we have seen some annotations, alt request controller, request body, path variable. We have not seen alt request param. We're going to show. I'll going to show that. Okay. Now I want to give some basic some concept before going to convert our application as a Spring default database. I told in the last video, I'm going to show this example using a database. Okay, that is Spring uses one default database called H2 database. I want to use that database to show these examples. Okay, before that, I want to give some theoretical information. The Postman, I showed all the example using Postman, right? In that, I used the content type. Content type, we call it application JSON. What is the meaning of that? Content type meaning what type of request you're going to set, what type of request you're going to set from the client side. Okay, set content type, say application JSON means I am sending the request to the server in the form of JSON. That is the reason I am saying here application / JSON. Okay, when you send this request to the server side, my Spring Boot application, our Spring Boot application consume that request and process it. By default, Spring process and process the handle JSON request and response. By default, we don't have to do anything. In some cases, I want to process XML based resource. In such a case, we have to do some minor changes in server side, then we can send request as a XML format and we can receive the response as a XML format. Okay, this topic is called as a content negotiation. Content negotiation. Okay, now we're going to see how to do that. In the header, first step is the header, we need to say accept equal to application / XML. So header is a so part of the request, part of the request, that is not a part of resource. This is the resource. Whatever request you are sending, that is a resource. Whatever request you are getting from the server, that is called as resource. Apart from resource, you want to give some information to the server. You want to say something to the server. Means those kind of additional information we need to set in the part of header. Okay. Content type, this accept will come under a header section. Apart from that, these are the custom predefined headers. If you want to set some custom header, that also possible. I will also show that example here itself. Okay. Now you need to say accept. You are saying that I'm going to send a XML request. That request should accept by the server. For that, I'm saying here accept equal to application / XML. I want to make sure that this XML request should process server. Okay, for that I have to do some changes in server side. Go to the server. My Spring Boot application is a server. Here we need to add one library dependency. This is com.fasterxml jackson.data format. Jackson data format XML. This artifact group ID you have to do. In our Spring Boot application, the JSON response request, this response request managed by our JSON data format only. Okay. Now we need to tell to the Spring Boot application, please manipulate XML based request also. For that, we need to add this particular dependency. That's it. You are done now. Okay. Now your Spring Boot application capable to handle XML based request and response. I'm going to restart my application. Okay, now server is started. The post method, I want to send XML based data. I want to send the XML resource. I want to convert this as XML data. Okay, I am done. Product ID, why gives here error here? Product ID. Then we need to add top parent tag is product. Just I'm following my model classes, that's it. My model class is having a product class. This product class has product class name I'm taking as the parent tag. Inside the parent tag I'm adding this all attributes, that's it, very simple. Now don't forget to change JSON to XML. No change, now the error is gone. Now I want to send this request to my server side. Okay, let's see. I want to restart my application. I want to show one thing. This is add product, right? I'm going to put debugger here. Debugger, okay. Debugger means we can execute the code line by line. We can see what's happening in the background. Okay, that is called test debugger. I want to start the server in the debugger mode. For that, you need to say right click debug. There's one optional debug. Okay, debug stock management application. Now I started the application. I given a breakpoint here. Okay, I given a breakpoint here. Whenever I come to this line, our application gets stopped here. I can go one by one. Okay, now I'm going to send the request. Now I am sending request. See here, it's come automatically. It's come to here. It's come and stop. It will not. It never execute until press this particular button. When you see the product. When you place the mouse on the product, when you expand that, you will get all the values. Product ID equal to 1, product name XYZ, product price 40, product stock count is 4. Whatever value I am passing here, that value get populated in product object. If you want to go next line, just click this. Okay. Initializing the array list and adding the product to array object. That's it. This is called as debugger. You are running your application debug mode to find out the issue. If you're facing some error, if you're facing some problem in your code, to find out the problem, debugging mode is a best approach. Okay. Okay. Now I added the one product by sending XML based request. I'm sending a resource in the form of XML based. Now I want to get. Now I want to get, okay. Let's see what's happening. I'll go and remove this. Let's see what's happening. Oh, here also I put debugger. I remove that. Okay, I'll get the resource as a XML. See, list. Because all the products available in the array list, right? That's the reason it's giving a list as a parent object inside that item enclosed with the product data. Product 1, product XYZ, 40 and 4. Now, I want to add one more product. To ARR 20. And the quantity is 19. Okay, 10. I am sent now. Oh, debugger, I remove the debugger. This is the error, right? If you click that, it'll run. Okay. Now I added the product. See, two more item added. Okay. So I'm able to, now my application is capable to handle JSON based request as well as JSON XML based request. Okay, then okay, I want to tell something. One more thing I want to tell. If you look at my controller, my this is my end, this is my, this is the server URL, this is the server URL. After that I am saying API. After that I am saying API. Under API I can have several resources. As of now I am showing only product. Okay, this endpoint determines that which resource you want access. Like that we need to structure the endpoint. We should not structure the endpoint your own. When you look at the endpoint, when someone look at the endpoint, those people should understand, okay, this endpoint going to access product, this endpoint going to access the customer, this endpoint going to access some employee information. Okay, when you read the endpoint itself, the endpoint should be readable, understandable by others. That is in that way only we need to come up with the web service endpoint URL. Okay. Now API, this localhost 8080 is my application. Under this application I constructed the API. Under that API I want access products. Like that you can say under that API I want access employees. Under that API I want access offers. Okay, this is a resource. Under the API I want access product resource, employee resource, offer resource. These two endpoint I have not implemented, but this endpoint implemented. So when you say here products, it will give all the products. If you going to say under this product, if you say get this, using this get endpoint I am able to retrieve all the products. If you say delete, I am able to delete all the products. If you say update, if you say put, I am able to update all the products. Okay, this is the way of constructing the your web service endpoint. Then if you say one, under the products I want access only one product, that is product ID is a 10, something like that 10. I can view the product 10 using get. I can delete the product 10 using delete. I can update the product using put. Then if you want to add something, you can say add. Okay, so this is more readable. Okay, so when you work with the project, you have to construct your endpoint like this only. Some cases are exceptional. For example, I want to do search. I want to search my product. In this case, I cannot go like that. For in such a case you can say search parameter, the query parameter, query parameter say product name equal to something like that. Okay, equal to XYZ something. Okay, this is the way of writing a search query. So I want to explain these things also part of this video. So I have explained what is content negotiation, what is header, and what is how to structure the endpoint URL. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to talk about some additional information about the header. So far we have seen some predefined header, content type and accept, like that predefined header we have seen. Header is nothing but additional information we are sending to the server. This is the resource. This resource I want to send to the server to add a product. Apart from this resource, I want to send my own headers. For example, I want to send country name. I want to know this client request coming from which country. I'll say India. Then I want to know country language. Yes, put language. Language, English. Okay. While adding this product, I want to pass these two information to the server. This is the product I'll going to add. Now the server said I wanted to slightly change something. There is a one annotation, add request header, part of this method. Here adding products add, right? So I need to add, I want to access this header information part of this method only. So I am adding one more parameter, add request header, map object, then headers. Now these headers will have all the headers which is coming from the client side. It is both predefined header as well as custom header. Now I'm going to start the server. I am going to start the server in debug mode. Okay. Right click, debug. So when I send this button, the control come to here and stop here. Then we'll see what is the values available in the header. Console, yeah, so already started now. I'll going to invoke this method now using this endpoint. I'm setting country name and language, then I'm sending this request. See, it'll come and stop here. See what is the value in header. See, there are lot of predefined header. Apart from that, I have added two more header, country name India, language English. That also coming here. I am going to print here everything. When I look at the console, I'm clearing the console. I'll go to next step. When next step over, when you click next step, this part will print. See? Country name India, language in English, and the other types, all types are coming here, all headers are coming. Okay. This is the purpose of headers. Okay, we can send our own header. Like here I am going to printing all the headers. Some cases I don't want to get all the headers. Why I need all the headers? I need whatever header I need, right? How to implement that? Very simple. Request header country name, I think value. What is this? Country name, then country, country name. Request header, another one is language. Country names. Then language. Language. Let's see what's happening. Now I want to access only the whatever header I need. Okay. I don't want other headers and all. Stop the server. Going to start in debug mode. I put a breakpoint here. Let's see what's the value in country name and the language. Start up the server. I'm going to send a request now. Before sending, I'm going to change the product to shirt 45 3. Okay, I'm changing the product information and sending the requested to requested. I'll click send button. Debugger point comes here. See here, country name India, language English. Go to console, clear this log, go step by step, start sprinter. Now country is going to print. Language prints. Okay, hopefully you understand that how to handle the headers, right? I think I'll going to stop this video from here. From next video, I'm going to convert this all endpoint manipulation with Spring Boot H2 database. Okay. please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.